Good morning, everyone. We're out here again in Red Rock Canyon, and I'm glad you're joining us. It's Tuesday, and what a great day. What a great day. You know, people say, oh, it's real hot. Well, it's only about 75 out here. That's a warm day, but gosh, it's nice. I wish you were here with us. In a way, you are. In a way, you are. And that's what we wanted, to come out and just give a scene of some fresh air. And while we're doing that, we're also doing a different thing. We're using Rick Warren's Open Doors Daily Devotional book to challenge ourselves and bless ourselves. And I hope you have a daily devotion book, if it's this one or some other one. Because just like this fresh air out here, it's refreshing to be in God's Word every morning. In a way, we want to make inspiration for today that also for you, because we always have at least a verse, many times many verses. So that's a good way to have your devotion. And this week we are literally having our devotion and letting Rick Warren speak to us. I do believe Rick is one guy who really listens to the Lord. And I have been blessed by his ministry now for many years before I was even at Saddleback, but I've been at Saddleback for 15 years. So that period of time for sure. Today, I'm just chose one out of February 14th because I really like this verse, and it comes from the parable of the sower. And I hope you know the four types of soils that the seed fell on. And this is the one that talks about when the seed, that is the Word of God, falls upon good soil. And that's us. That's us who are the followers of Christ, the children of God. In Luke 8:15, it says, "The seeds that fell in the good soil, for those who hear the message and retain it in a good and obedient heart, and they persist until they bear fruit." That's one of the neat things about being a follower of Christ, is it not? That we get to bear fruit for Him. And that, of course, is one of the hard things that we're doing right now as we go through this stay-at-home pandemic time of year. It's hard because so many of us were blessed by the ministry that God gave us, and a lot of that ministry had to do with being active in the church. I hope you're still active in your small group. That's one way to stay connected, but I sure look forward to the time, and it's getting closer, when we will get together again to worship Him together. Here's what Rick says about that verse. God speaks to the person who decides in advance to do whatever God says to do. God doesn't speak to the person who says, "Hey God, tell me what you want me to do and then I'll decide if it's a good idea or not." No, God's not going to waste His time on that. You have to say in advance, "God, I am willing to cooperate with whatever you want me to do. I'm signing a blank check. You fill it in, Lord." Jesus says people who listen to God with an obedient heart are like rich soil where a seed can grow into a plant that bears fruit. Notice the four traits of the people who respond to God's word in faith. They hear it, they retain it, they obey it, and they persist in it until they bear fruit. Boy, that's a challenging few things, isn't it? But that's what we should be doing. That's what God's Word does say. But of course, and I asked this question a lot especially when I was younger. How do you bear fruit? It's by obeying God's Word continually. Well, this is persistence, that we keep living in obedience until we see fruit. The fruit doesn't come before persisting. If it did, we wouldn't grow spiritually. And then Rick asks these questions. Do you want to hear from God? Well, then you have to decide in advance, before you even open your Bible, that you will obey God's word. Commit to doing whatever God tells you to do. God is ready to speak to you, so get ready to listen. Well, that's kind of my words to you, that you got to persist until we bear fruit. And as I said before, for some of us, that's really hard because we're not meeting together as a church, and a lot of our fruit is ministering within the body of Christ. But you know, here's what I've been thinking. I know that when we get to restart, it's almost, in some ways, it's like starting church over again. We're going to have to make sure that everyone even remembers what we do. And, you know, because like those who make coffee, please remember to come when we announce when to start and make our coffee. We have to have that. But all the hospitality, all the greeters, all, what's your role? I know that you remember it, and it's not church without you. And so I know in one sense there's going to be a temptation to say, well, I've been being blessed at home, and I love watching the sermon. But remember, that's just it. You watch the sermon. No one says to me, Rick, I like to worship at home. No one ever says that. You know why? They don't worship. Worship is very difficult to do alone and at home. In fact, there's so many. The Bible has something like 80 one another's. Love one another, encourage one another, pray for one another, on and on, 80 of those. If there's one another, then that's something that you can't do alone. So we need to get back together, and we need to be doing these things. I pray that you just keep looking forward to that day, and then, like we just read, God, if you're asking me to do it, or maybe something else, and if it is something else or whatever, I am ready, willing, and then God, you make me able. Sometimes, don't you often feel that way? We don't feel able to do what God calls us to do. That's okay. What we're really looking forward to is just the fact, if you make yourself available, He'll make you able. So that's what we're doing, and that's what we're sowing. Look at this view with me. Isn't that something that God created over time? It's just a phenomenal thing. By the way, I encourage you, don't miss Friday's show. Friday is our 4th of July show, and we're going to celebrate this country. We have a lot of scenes from this national park available that we're going to use, but many, many other things we're going to do. So Friday is a show that you don't want to miss. So as you can, maybe you can tell, we're out here and we're having some people go by on bikes and lots going on. That's fun. People are out here enjoying the park. Well, I hope you've been enjoying this outdoor scenery. We've had a lot of noise on the outside of people enjoying it. I don't think that came through to you, but if it did, then just know that that was people having fun and enjoying God's creation out here. And I love it too. This is just one fine mountain that you see. I appreciate it. Well, friends, this has been fun. God bless. Have a great day, and we will see you tomorrow.